Okay, so. Ja, as you can see, guys, Duran, I have Calculate Linux back. And it's not just back. It came back to the rescue again. I mean, wow. I mean, yeah. So I had trouble with MX18.1 on this computer, the brand new computer, with the GTX 1050i, to get that World of Tanks game running. Funny thing is, I believe that no, this comes as a surprise to you. Yeah, I know. I might have made a mistake. I think I used the backport NVIDIA graphic, and this didn't seem to work well. So then I tried to get Magia on. I couldn't get Magia to fire up. I think Magia is, my personal opinion here now, struggling with NVIDIA graphic cards, but I can choose whatever I want. I can go for the proprietary drivers. Doesn't fire up. 6 didn't work, 6.1 didn't work. Next time I will try 7. See if that got it getting through, because 7 should hopefully get ready soon. That would be nice to see. I was left now without playing my most hated game. And so then I thought, me, Ubuntu again, but then why did I buy the PC if I have to run Ubuntu again? Because here it goes. Shame on me, I know. I had a little doubt that Calculate Linux would just do everything again, as it always did. And it does. This is my beloved Calculate Linux, and it is as beautiful as it always is. And funky thing is, it does everything I wanted to do, everything. I installed my most hated game, World of Tanks, fired up, can play it. Everything is just doing okay. I've got my G scanner here. I just have to change it again to that it is not getting the feeder here flatbed. Okay, all you do, you press your button, scan, takes a little moment to wake the printer up, then it scans, and everything is just work like I'm used to. I'm so long off my Calculate Linux because of my cursed Optimus gaming laptop that I had doubts that this would be a good system, but it really, really is. Then the other hand, on the other hand, I dare to put it on my solid state drive. I mean, yeah, I did go there. So you see, scanner works fine. Everything is doing okay. No hassle, no fuss. Everything just works. And so far, what did I do? The first thing when I booted up, I installed it totally no problem. While I installed, I choose the NVIDIA proprietary driver. I give it a home too, so it has a calculate home extra partition even on the spinning hard drive, while the operating system itself sits on the solid state drive. So then I fired it up. And I waited for the updater to show up here on the top, because I didn't want to trigger it manually. I want to see what the system does. First, it took some time. I said, okay, so I installed Porthole. Then I fired up Porthole as root. What did I install? Something very uneventful. I forgot what I installed first. Little things. And then the updater showed up, said, yeah, this is what I was waiting for. So I run the update, reboot it. And yeah, it's doing okay. After that, after Portal, then I will run Portal again. GKSU is not available anymore. And that is a boomer. So if I go here as root. Oh, yeah, no, I thought I burned some USB stick here. So if I go in Portal. Which is not a big deal. So if I go for GKSU, not there anymore. Doesn't exist. Which is totally weird. So now I'm stranded. I would need something to run it. Would be nice to have. Didn't have any trouble to install the HP printer, but I must say I did it as root, I think. So the HP dash setup, yeah, that's what I used. So here it's not there. No GKSU. Nope, no can do. So if somebody knows what else I could use, that would be great. But meanwhile, I must say, so I installed Chromium, installed Google Chrome, I installed Thunderbird, G-Scan, HTOP was there. I used Simple Screen Recorder this time because I installed OBS, but it didn't show, and I can't fire it up on the terminal either because it seems I can't find it. Not a big deal. I just use Simple Screen Recorder. Works totally fine. I think the sound quality is actually good too. And man, I got my Calculate Linux back. Look at this. Look at this. And fast as snappy as this. Oh, look at, I mean, bang. You push the button, it's there, right? Did you see that? Doing. Right away. So that's pretty neat. I had no trouble. I unpacked, like with AR space dash X, I unpacked the DEP files from Synology. The drive works without trouble. Oh, here it is. So Synology drive, that's my drive. And if I go in HTOP, I think you can see it running. I don't know what I did. I don't know. Let's have a look. I just fired up one more time. Let's see. I think it's actually running. That is right. So I click it away. And it should be somewhere running in the background. I think because it's idling, you can't see much of it. Which is okay too. But it works. I had a nice display icon, and now it's gone. It's just what it is. Synology Notes does not fire up. I had trouble copying something over with my Midnight Commander, even as root. But I will fix that. What I'm going to do is I will install MX18.1 one more time. Then I will choose no backports for the NVIDIA graphic card, and that might just sort everything out. In between, I tried to figure out getting some help here. Some people try, but it seems to be a mystery, and it could be that I used, I'm not 100% sure, the backport driver, and that might have caused trouble. I don't know. It's very unusual to have it, but I do have it, and that's just what there is, right? So, otherwise than that, after I installed everything I need, and I must say, yeah, good, if GKSU would work, everybody would have an extreme normal experience. But let me try something here. If I go back to my user, can I go SU? Oh. Would that work? No. Oh, yeah. I didn't do this. It happened all by itself. Oh, dear me. What did I do? So, however, I really would love to see GKSU or something. I need something to be able to sudo in. I didn't out myself as sudoer now. I think. Yeah. Let's see. I mean, I want to see. Maybe Sergi, maybe, it's Gentoo, does Gregor, Irish, they should know, these three should know what to use, because GKSU isn't available anymore. That's a boomer, that's really, really bad. Redshift, I don't have GeoClue 2 available either, so I put my coordinates in manually. Oh dear me, now I've got the shame there forever, will never go away. So if you go here in Portal, then you can see. It's kind of weird that if I go for GeoClue, it shows. But look, there is no GeoClue 2. And Redshift would be looking for GeoClue 2, but it's not there. It's a little bit weird, right? Is it not? I mean, yeah. Why is it not there? I don't know. So, Notes don't run, so I had the same trouble with Magia when it was running. I couldn't get Synology Notes, there was a dependency missing, I think a higher version from lib. Here, because I don't have an installer for it, I just unpacked it, I had trouble copying it, and I believe that might be the issue. Yeah, knowing, I don't know. So, can't get GeoClue 2, it's not there, don't have GKSU, or GK, yeah. GKSU. It's not there. I don't have anything to use my authorization as root to do something or change something. It doesn't work. It's not working. Anything else? I think I didn't install. Yeah, I did my home partition here, my no home. So if I go in Yeah, there is no home, right? That's where I have everything. VirtualBox. Oh, yeah, VirtualBox is the next thing that I have to install. And then everything is just doing totally okay. So I'm very, very happy with it. Because VirtualBox shouldn't be a big deal to get it installed again. Having said this, no, but with Calculate Linux usually wasn't a problem. It's actually very quickly done, and that's pretty good. So, you know what? Let me search for it. F3, and I just use Drive. Synology Drive. Yeah, here, see, it's running. So how did I get there? I used F3 and I just wrote Drive. Then I know it's running in the background. So that's good with me. I can click that away. Overall, that is the experience I'm used to with Calculate Linux. I'm really, really happy I got it back. At least that didn't give me any hassle. And I used the installer from December, 28th of December 2018. That was the installer I used, and it's doing a great job. Having said this, here is one subscriber. Enough, Otso. He's asking what kind of distro to use. If you have very little experience with Linux or almost none, I would still say MX18 is pretty good. I know, guys, the traitor. If you have very, very little experience too, then maybe Linux Mint and Xubuntu. And that is, I mean, with MX18, if you don't know, if you have very little experience, let it format your hard drive and let it do its thing and make up backups of your data, of course, because then it will install a second home partition, and then you are ready to go for years to come to update everything, because you have to have a second partition for home. Calculinux, if you can watch videos and type these things in, that is it. It's very, very simple. It has a graphic card installer for everything you can ever have. Magia, usual 2. Magia 6.1, that should do. If you can fire it up, I do believe now that they struggle to get something with NVIDIA graphic cards through. Because I can't fire it up, and this is a total normal PC. This is just a PC with a simple single NVIDIA graphic card, the GTX 1050i. And I can't get Magia 6 or 6.1 to boot up here. It stucks forever. I can't press I can't press F2, but it doesn't do anything. I can't see where it stucks, what it is doing. I let it run for quite some time. I said maybe I can't see, and it's patience, patience. That didn't work either. Patience doesn't work. So here, sudo reboot is pretty good. If you're using Windows, why does it matter what browser you use? You always 100% the backdoor. Oh, it's just great. Yeah, that was great. However, so yeah, what video did he get for Microsoft to warn Windows 10 users not to install Chrome or Firefox? Yeah, to be honest, don't use Microsoft. Not at all. And Firefox, no, watch that video. So I think that's pretty okay. Yeah, so I don't have much. This is the same situation I had with MX. How can I say this? Once you installed your operating system, usually it just works. It just does its thing. And there's not much to do. Just let it do its thing. It's, yeah, I don't see any trouble here. You know, I got the thing going, right? So yeah, the next thing is VirtualBox, and then I have everything installed on my Calculate Linux to make it 100% work for me. I don't have my Synology nodes, that's a boomer, but I will get that to work. I will get this to work. There will be a way, and I will show you what I do when I do it. But for that, I have to install MX18. And then we go from there. That will be very interesting. Actually, not. It's totally simple. I'm a very simple mind when it's about computers, because I just, you know, there are zero and ones. It's not much to remember, and that will do. However, I think I cut that video short. I have to go out again for, I think, 2 hours or something. Then I will play a game, see how it does. I mean, the game is rigged and not very enjoyable, but I enjoy getting it running. So that's actually the game. And, yeah, totally happy. I got my calculated Linux back! But as everybody knows, my philosophy is have 2 independent operating systems running on your computer, and with independent I mean Calculate Linux is Gentoo based, MX is for example Debian based. That's pretty okay because they are not from the same base. I would love to get Magia working. I will try the 7 version. You know, let's do it while we do it here. Magia 7. Download Magia 7 Beta 2. Okay, I had Beta 1. Network installer live media. GNOME. Oh! 64-bit. I'll use the direct link this time. So it should show up here somewhere. Doink. Also, here it is. Here's Magia 6.1. Here's another one. I fresh downloaded. Didn't make any difference. So now let's see then later what the 7 version does, right? So here it's coming in. These are nice download speeds, right? I tell you, when you were on it's called MTS, and they're a terrible, terrible network. I did get lucky 3 megabytes. Not even 3 megabytes, no. It was a nightmare, just... Now it's you can download something and actually watch it. So then, I need a USB stick for that. Oh, which one? I have so many and don't want to sacrifice any. Let's see what I have here. Oh, these are my Xpenology bootloaders here. Yep, that's Xpenology. Let's see, I want to have those. So I'm plugging USB sticks in here and I watch here to see what's coming up. Transfer, okay, no. Alright, you know what? I just do it. I use. Because here I have a Ubuntu USB stick. See, here's Ubuntu 16.04, the totally naked. Normal version. I might install that too. Xubuntu. And we will see what it does. I do have to go into ISO. Doink. Because here it will show up my Magia. So then I go in my terminal. And I use it, what's it called? This, the DD command to write my USB sticks. So show in folder, in ISO, what's it called? Magia 7 Beta 2. So properties, I copy the whole thing. Copy. Did I copy it? Copy. Close. And then here I look for what I did last was MX. Here's the ISO. Let me show you. Otherwise, you might get confused. So then I go paste Duran, and it should still be SDB. So just make a double check that I have the right USB stick and not kill something important. Ignore. SDA, SDB is my USB stick. Yes, okay, so then I can fire it up, right? No media found? Are you kidding me? Failed? How can I not find it? Oh! Okay. Oh. What was that? That was MX, what I burned here, I think. Oh, hold on. I have to go back and forward here. MX Live. Okay, that is my MX18. That's what I'm going to install next. And here's SDP, so that should work. Let's try. Ah, yeah, okay. So the struggle I had, I have a, what's it called? A USB switch, almost like a KVM. And when I plugged it into that USB port, it couldn't find it. Now I plugged it right into the computer, and now I can just work with it. Totally weird. However, so I'm writing now a GL7 Beta 2, and I'll give it a shot from there. Let's see what it does. We cannot judge Magia on the beta version. Would be a little bit unfair. I know that their beta versions are not like anybody else's, where most people get a beta version out, which just seems to be all ready to go. That's not the case with Magia usually, but once it's ready to go, it's usually a really good thing. So, yeah, I've got my MX18.1. I think that's the first one I use. I want to see if I made the mistake and used backports and if that screwed up everything else. Which would be terrible, right? So I've got my paperwork here. I had to schedule 10 more students. I think I put everything in a calendar. That should have worked. And yeah, today work continues. Just knowing like six. Oh, La Riviere today. Mm-hmm. Well, we'll be okay. Oh, and have tonight another. Tonight. So it will be late tonight. So if I come with the next video. So I hope I won't make too long. I might even fire up Magia 7 quick to see if it at least boots. I want to see if it boots and I can install it. That's why I chose the live media. If I can't even get in that, then there's no way to make it. So this will take quite some time, I guess. You don't have to sit and wait for it. That's just Badidi command to copy, not to copy, to burn a USB stick. That's what I use on Calculate Linux. And it's doing a good job. And this is it, guys. This is Calculate Linux. It came to the rescue. It does everything right now. The last piece missing is VirtualBox, and I come to it a little bit later. And then we go from there. I mean, while we do this, see, we can go SU. So, and if I go to Portal, here's Portal, doink. I could install VirtualBox again. Or I can do it from the... let's just have a look. Of course, I could install VirtualBox. I would go for the bin version. Does it install? Dependencies. Oh, so little, yeah. Calculating dependencies. Modules. Okay, it pulled modules. One of two. It gets modules and VirtualBox, I guess. Yeah, in a moment it's just modules. Job 0 of 2. Let's see what it takes, right? VirtualBox bin, okay, that's a normal VirtualBox. As a binary. So let's see what it, oh, that is already everything. Yeah, okay. It's just VirtualBox and VirtualBox modules what it is pulling right now, so it says it's complete. Okay, let's see if it's complete. It's not there yet. It always takes a little moment, yeah, to show up. Okay. VirtualBox bin and modules. So where could they put it? Others? No. Office? No. Games development all. I can't remember that it took so long for VirtualBox to show up. It's a no-go in a moment. This is the writing. So, do you know what? I unmerge the whole thing. And we go back to my little brain. So I've got Linux tweaks here. I go search file content. And then I go VirtualBox. So, and if I go here, calculate Gentoo, Funto, VirtualBox, arrow fixed, calculate Linux, Gentoo, VirtualBox, install. So here it is. So I just copy the whole thing, what I have here. Open. Terminal. Then I make that a little bit bigger that you guys can see. Then I copy a long string of stuff in. So I have modules here and additions. Oh yeah, okay, VirtualBox extra pack. Okay, I just use the whole thing. I fire it up and that should nicely install everything. Then the next thing is I have to add myself to the VBox user group. And if I would have trouble, then I know what to do here too, because would you like to merge these packages? Yes. So we're doing that. And it actually doesn't hurt as much, right? So I can close portal, I think, because... Let's see. Okay, we just let this do its thing. I'm not interfering any more than I screwed up. I'm good in screwing things up if I were impatient, right? I want to do so many things at once. So, Instance 3 out of 4, emulation VirtualBox, module 6.04. That seems to be all working. USB stick is still writing. What does my CPU say? See, it's a 6-core, it's the i5-8400. It's actually doing okay, I guess. I mean, except I trust it will have somewhere a backdoor to spy on you. Sadly, Intel isn't what everybody else does. NVIDIA does different things. They bring a card out, like a GT1030, I think it is, with DDR5, and everybody's in, whoa! And then... very silently, they changed the model to a DD4, which is totally worse in performance, but it's very hidden somewhere, like wargaming, you know, hidden stats, yeah, where they hide the information, and then you get a graphic card where you say, what the heck, that is no performance. And then they say, yeah, did you not see in page 10.10.10 and use the special liquid to make the small print visible? Right? So to me, this is fraud. It is it's nothing else than any other criminal is using, trying to deceive people, right? Like a picking pockets and stuff like that. There's no other. It's exactly the same to me. So, but what that means to me now when I got that installed, it did. Then I add myself here to that group. And done. And now I would have to reboot. And I will do that. Let's see if VirtualBox is visible. Oh, that's why it didn't show up. I didn't reboot. Ah, remember. Yeah, that was it, guys. That was it. That's why I couldn't see it. Because usually when you install VirtualBox, you have to reboot and then it shows up. So now it's done right. See, because I have two more things copied or installed. And I had a video out about it, so it's all there. If somebody needs another video how to install VirtualBox, let me know. Then I just copy and paste the command into the... I added anyway. I put it in this description, how to add VirtualBox. All right. But I made the video already where it is. So this should be any moment done here, I hope. What did I burn here? I forgot. Okay, my GR7 bitter too. Let's see what that does. That would be interesting to see. With my GR6, 6.1, I cannot get it to boot on this computer. And I plug it direct into this computer's USB ports. And it's a no-go. No. Doesn't want to boot. It boots, but it doesn't fire up. I can't get to the graphical interface or anything else. It just freezes. Which is a weird behavior. Let's see if 7 does the same thing. I think it's a little bit like what Das Gregor said in his FreeBSD video, that all these companies working sadly in the background to make our, us Linux users, life very difficult. And for that, they usually wouldn't deserve our money. So in that case, it's pretty good what Das Gregor said, that he bought a laptop from System76, that we support those who build hardware for Linux. Yeah, so that would be a good thing to do. So this one will be done soon, any moment, and it will be okay. I will switch, stop this video now and upload it, and then I have to get ready almost. I will try to see at least firing up my GS7, see if that boots and if I can do something. If it boots up, then I install it right away, right? Why not do it while what's already there? Okay, then I will install again MX18, and then I will be very carefully what I'm going to do with my NVIDIA graphic card driver. Mm-hmm. So we have to see what it does. I might just fire it up, install this NVIDIA graphic driver, don't run any updates, then I go up, boot up again, see if I can install this World of Tanks game, see if it all works, and if it does, then I go and fire it up, update it. Let's see, I will try to this approach. I'll let you guys know what's coming out. If you hear me swearing and ranting, then it did not work as expected. But as I said, I still think I give it a good chance that I used the backport NVIDIA graphic driver and that this did maybe some funky stuff to me. Well, we will see, I guess. All right, this is it. That video is out. I think we have the best sound quality on this operating system, which is Calculate Linux. And based on Gentoo, so you have everything from Gentoo, if you want. So there's just the layman repro running from Calculate Linux, which makes it Calculate Linux. Everything else is pure Gentoo. So if you want to go pure Gentoo, you can install Calculate Linux, take the layman out. But why would you do that? Calculate Linux has so many really good tools you can use. So I would just keep with it. I mean, that's what I do. I'm the lazy guy. I want it simple. I have a good-looking, very stable, snappy, reliable, do everything you want it to do operating system with Calculate Linux. Very reliable, rolling release, so I don't have to install it ever again in 150 years coming. Everything is doing okay. And these guys are pretty reliable. I think they're in the 11th year of Calculate Linux now. I think they do it now for 11 years. Or even 12, I can't even say. Shame on me. However, that is that. I will switch that video off, upload it, and stay tuned, guys. I hope I find the mistake with MX18.1, and then it would be all okay. If you don't lose, you play World of Tanks, don't you worry about a thing. I think MX will just do fine. But if it my thing is, if it causes trouble with that game, it might cause trouble with something you want to try at some day. So let's see if we can fix it, right? All right, guys, so save recording. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'll see you soon, guys. Bye.